Okay.
So are you wanting to do more drops or what are you wanting to play?
Let's you can tell me kind of where you think my game, you know, my drops.
Yeah.
Kind of like the same. I just like to learn how do I get to think about it.
Think about what?
Like you said, when you're dinking, you want to be able to make someone move at least one or two steps to the left or to the right.
Yeah. I mean, there's like corners on that. So
corners.
Corner. Yeah. And then if they start cheating and they hit one here, they already start going here. They
go right back.
Yeah, it's a corner.
Yeah.
But mostly, yeah, corner, corner.
Corner.
Yeah. above the net like that,
yeah,
you should be going over the ball.
Like,
so like yeah, I'm like going over it. Yeah, you're kind of under time to or just like that. There's no yeah. So basically, metrics for it. So if it's like right above the net, you're like this.
Okay.
And then as it gets lower, you start opening. Then as it gets higher, you just do basically the same thing. You still punch forward.
Yeah.
But with the outward angle, it will ascend it down.
So it's kind of like a
yeah.
The paddle.
Yeah, it's like a scale. So
yeah.
you're like all the time like
I'm like this.
Yeah.
No matter where it's at.
So just change it based on how high it is.
Okay.
Try to aim at the knee, so like,
okay. I noticed that. I was like, hey, Austin's kind of giving me a break right now. He could probably retire.
Yeah, just go at the knees. And with how hard it is, it won't come back. There you go. Keep getting better than knees. Do it. Just don't miss.
Oh.
That was a good one.
Thanks. That was a good hand.
Yeah. So the nice thing with like ending like So, yeah, I mean, that's basically it. You think of like Jackie Irvin or something?
Yeah.
Like, they like that's how she gets all of her powers. Like,
yeah.
So, anyways, you can do a similar thing. I don't do it all the time, but like, yeah, you just, yeah. Just like with your thing, you're usually dropping your mitts and it's usually a little weaker.
Yeah.
So, yeah, just talk to the backhand for that.
Yeah,
that's also looking good.
Okay. So if I'm coming back across, it's just...
Thank you. So I know you're on the run, etc. That one, and I think it, I'm just mentioning it because I think it happens, right?
Yeah.
You let it get too close to you, and then you like bring your elbow in, but it keeps your elbow out. So like
you did notice. Right? Like, yeah, okay. Yeah.
Yeah. So like all the time, forehand and backhand when you're thinking, keep elbow out. Really try not to like get like that. And then if you completely don't know what I'm doing, it doesn't hurt to block it, like
reset it.
Yeah, block it into the kitchen or block it at my knees.
Fucking no, yeah.
Taking that full swing, you kind of like have it hang on your paddle for a second.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not saying it's bad, but also if you don't have it hang on your paddle like perfect this way,
oh, you fly
it. It will go out. Like not necessarily high up, but it will go long. Like it has to come. Right?
So why is that happening? Is it because of catching?
Well, I mean, if you catch it and like kind of throw it like really good, I mean, it's not going to matter what angle it is.
Uh-huh.
But if you like. You just have way more forgiveness if you're here and like the ball's just gonna like naturally go in, like it's gonna go in way more, it's gonna be way nicer for you.
Okay.
And that's really because we all have limited talent and skill, right? I'm gonna run out of luck with my talent, right? The more it can just be automated where the ball's just gonna go in and I don't have to worry about it.
Uh-huh.
And super good, I will just go in. That's where we play better. Good one. Good.
Break the clock time.
Tap in your drop, buddy. Yeah, I got a lot in Florida in the next little bit.
Oh, nice.
And then one in Texas.
How do you pick partners? Do you just call them the week before? Or you call them like, hey, you want to play this tournament with me? Or
it's like dating, but like polygamy's a thing.
Okay.
There's no such thing. Like monogamy is not.
So how does it go? Like you.
You're trying to get the best partner you can, and whoever your partner is trying to get the best partner they can. And so, no, that's often there are like super win wins.
Right. Right.
So if you can find someone you're really excited to play with, and they're really excited to play with you.
Yeah.
Then that's really nice. But it's pretty hard to get that every time.
Right, so you kind of just gotta go whatever, yeah, like.
Right. And then even if someone's not like super excited for you, if you can perform really well, then
they're more likely to.
Yeah, I mean, you might not be the prettiest girl to dance, but if you can dance really good, something.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Give that volley a little more attention. I think if you're resetting it, like, really hit wherever you're trying to hit.
Nope, that was perfect.
You see with all these things and volleys, like, hit it the corner. Don't hit it slow. If you hit it slow, you're going to the top.
You get pushed back a little bit farther. Is it okay to take that step back and push? Like, okay, I'm gonna take this step back, my arm, and direct it that way.
Sure.
Because I've heard it where you don't want to move.
Right.
This is where you want.
If you can take it out of the air or if you don't have to move back, that's ideal.
Okay.
If you're back here, usually you're in a little bit of a less good situation.
Okay.
Where, but also, if you come back here, hit one shot, and come right back up, it's not too bad. But also, if you're going to miss the one out of the air, but instead you let it bounce and take a step back, hit it, and then come back up, that's much better than missing.
Okay.
So, yeah, it's not as good, but yeah, if you want to experiment with it right now, I'll let you know my pick.
Okay. I thought I could take it out.
Thank you. I think more of the issue is when you give me a complicated ping or a dead ping, like where it's like I don't have to move at all and it's really slow and it's gonna bounce up like 3 or 4 feet. That's more of the issue.
Okay.
So I really try to avoid that, hit the corners with some tension. Like you don't need to take, you can throw a frisbee like this.
Yeah.
You don't need to take. even if you're not trying to throw the pitch too hard, you're gonna like have more control over it with your whole body rather than just like trying to like rather than just a wrist to your heart.
Oh shit! I should have that one.
Late, like, do it or don't do it.
Yeah.
do the volleys where you just like place it less like this and more, well, I guess less with the wrist down and more just like straight? So like here rather than here?
Let's try.
Yeah.
So
I'll one day it'll pop up.
Thank you. punch it.
Sometimes that's life.
So often do you play every day?
I'm obsessed.
God, I love this game. Just wish that I just get out and play more.
Drive 30 minutes to play with better players. It's just whoever sacrifices more usually wants to keep count that he's going to benefit the most. Or improve.
Right.
Well, let's maybe go straight the other way. A little variety. Congratulations. Your dinks went from. Your dinks and your fast hands went from 4-0 at the night to 4-5.
Sweet.
And I'm not saying that's necessarily where they're always at, but.
Right.
Okay, here we go. Once again, it seems like most people can't do the background, but just feel a little cover is kind of important.
Alright.
And then here, we'll talk about it.
Yeah.
Yeah, at a certain point, it's kind of like the Bible, in that it's like Jesus is saying, if your eye offend me, pluck it out, arm offend me, cut it off. Like, it'd be nice to have two arms, but if your arm is going to kill you, cut off the arm. So, same with like
top spin
being, kind of like backhand drive from the baseline. Like, you can do it great, but at a certain point, you have to be like,
no.
You just have to like, come to yourself and be like, is this really working? And like, can I fix it in a reasonable amount of time? And if it's like, no. And this is also true in tournaments. It's like, okay, normally my backhand drop is really good. But then in a tournament, it's maybe not working. It's like, okay, well, like, can I fix this? No? Yeah, I can only do forehand drops. And I have to like figure that out the best I can.
Okay.
But anyways, there's just like, interesting thoughts.
No.
I've had that before though, like where it's only after one tournament to me ever.
Okay.
But like my backhand roll,
yeah.
One tournament it was my worst shot of all my game. Like it was really bad.
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, it's not getting better. I can't do this today.
Okay.
And it's never happened again. you have to be able to realize that kind of stuff.
Yeah. Oh.
Thank you. if you could send it in the box and fry the leisure, you're sacrificing the consistency though. So if anything, I'd say just be really close attention when you're doing it, make sure you don't miss. Like, it's like you're driving and there's ice on the road. Normally there's not any benefit to ice on the road, but imagine there's some benefit, but all of a sudden you could die. So yeah, don't die. Like, do some nice car tricks instead. I don't think anyone can really do it with once a week, honestly.
Yeah.
It's just too tough.
Alright.
Not when you're like trying to compete with someone who's doing 5 times a week, but
you're doing 5 a week, if you're really smart about it, then
come on, dudes.